The final clue, 6 days ago, a human skull was found in a creek in Spartanburg County.
And it took a real-life CSI forensics investigation to find out who it belonged to. And 7 News reporter Brianna Smith got to be part of that. Brianna, you actually sat down with the forensics team. We understand that you have exclusive details right from the coroner's office.
Yeah, it was actually really interesting to be a part of it. But we just learned that from a forensic investigation, they believe that that skull belongs to a Caucasian man in his 50s. And we've also learned that bones were found, more of them actually, over the past week. And they could be just hours away from actually IDing who this skull belongs to. I got to interview the anthropologist who helps the coroner's office break these cases.
These bones are fused together.
When it comes to putting together the pieces, forensic anthropologist Dr. Shana Williams has a bone that comes out on top.
If I could pick the one that helps me the most, it's going to be the skull.
Which came in handy when Spartanburg coroner Rusty Clevenger called her last Wednesday to help solve who a skull found under a bridge on Double Branch Road belonged to.
The evidence we're looking for is a lot more definitive on bone or, identifying the processes that we see on bone to get to some closure for the family.
Dr. Williams used this skeleton that was donated to Greenville Health System to show us how she was able to answer questions about the skull in question.
For instance, the thickness of the superior orbital margin, it's going to be thicker with men versus women.
She's also going to check the brow line and where the muscles pull from on the back of the neck and cheekbones to identify race, and then determine how long the bones were there and if there was any trauma.
So that's where I would look for sharp force trauma, blunt force trauma, or gunshot wounds. So that would give some sort of insight as to what events occurred around this person's death.
And once those questions are answered, Coroner Clevenger is left to put the rest together and bring this family peace.
In this instance, I'm glad someone notified law enforcement so we could, at least start a process for getting this family, whenever I'm able to make a positive identification, some closure.
You could tell that Dr. Williams is extremely intelligent in her field, and I got to be involved in so much science, it's hard to pull it all together in 1 minute. So an interesting piece that we didn't include was actually, if you've ever had a surgery, I've had a broken arm back in 98, they would know that in your medical records. If that showed on your bones, they would be able to piece that together with your medical records, which is something they're doing in this case right now.
Well, the science in all of this is so fascinating. At the same time, there's a very human side, a personal side for the family that's involved here. They want to know what's happened to their loved one. Any idea when that could happen?
Well, Rusty Clevenger told me, he said, I've had so many police agencies call me about missing persons cases as soon as we found this out. And after finding out that it's a white man in his 50s, they're a little bit closer. They hope as soon as they connect those medical records that they'll be able to give us an identification in a couple days.
All right, more on that really soon. Thank you, Brianna.